off the exit, the main road and mission with Conway. And till this day, Conway is, I mean, the bloodline right all the way through from the expressway all the way through 107.
The community is wonderful, and it's these type of matchups that brings out the best in everybody. Symbolizes is that every kid can be a Hall of Famer in this district. Every kid that's coming out here, and it might not be in football, but that football field is a symbolic front for everybody to follow, and that this isn't going to be the first or the last one out of Mission.
Always had tradition, you know, they've always had athletes, and you know, I first got the job at Mission here, they honored the top 50 athletes here in the valley, and 9 of them out of the 50 which had the most were mission people. You know, and you talk about like the Detmers, you know Lupe Rodriguez, Nati Valdez, Frank Hernandez, Eliseo Pompa, you know, there was a bunch of them. Just see by that alone that there's a lot of tradition here.
What I've come to find out about Mission is they have high expectations, you know, not only from the community to the people, but from themselves. And so then you have the Detmers and Taylors, and they proved, hey, they're in the biggest show there is. So when you talk about Mission and you speak about Mission football, people from all around the nation know what we're talking about. What separates us is that we know that we're called to greater things, and we're willing to put all the sacrifice, energy, dedication to reach our full potential. And that's why you see so much greatness come out of this awesome, awesome school district.
We've got to look at the legendary Tom Landry Stadium. It's named after Tom Landry. We've got the Hall of Fame logo on our field. You know, there's only 2 in the whole nation, one's at Canton, Ohio, and the other one's here at Mission. So there's a lot of pride when you talk about Mission in general, you know.
The history and the success of Mission football, beginning back with Tom Landry, then we kind of fell off the map for a little while. Then when Coach Lee and his group brought it back in, and you know, and turned it around and made Mission a football city, one of the greatest, you know, obviously in the valley, but even in the state. You know,
I mean, you don't have to say much else besides Tom Landry went here, and the stadium is Tom Landry Stadium, and you know, that is something that, you know, if you're a football fan, should give you chills.
Players, you know, it's all about the bragging rights for our fans. The west side, Mission is divided by Conway, you know, west side, east side. And
within our boundary, I try to stay between Stewart and Conway, because that's where we exist as a school, and Patriot athletic programs live in between there.
But it's a clean break. You know, there's no ifs, ands, or buts. If you're on this side, you go to one school. And if you go to this other side, you go to the other. And when you drive down that street, whether you're heading north or heading south, you could see old Mission on one end and you can see new Mission on the other. Cut it right in the middle, man. It's very unique. It's a true east-west rivalry. There's a line, and it's called Conway.
Definitely a west side and an east side, you know, and that's what you always hear. So, I mean, you couldn't have it any better than that. It's perfect right down the line. You know?
From the last 7 years, the time that myself and our staff that we came in, I'm real proud of what we've accomplished. Since this staff has come into play in the last 6 years, we've been in the playoffs 5 times. We've won 2 bi-district championships. Are we satisfied? No. Is that good enough? Of course not. But the improvement that this staff and the football program has had in the last 6 years has been tremendous to me, and I'm proud of what the kids that have been a part of it and the coaching staff have done over the last 6 years.
Hey, you practice with a purpose. There's only one purpose this week, right?
Yes,
there's only one purpose this week. Practice with a purpose. Do everything with the intent to be successful. Every play, every rep you get this week, every rep.
You gotta protect that quarterback. You gotta protect him.
There you go. You better drop.
Get there, good.
First and foremost, we're dedicating our football season to Coach Martin Salazar, who passed away last December 2014. The kids, are definitely playing in his memory, and it's like we've told the kids, you know, if he could be here, man, you know, he bled maroon and white, and so we are dedicating this football season to Coach Salazar. They had in one district since Mission split into two schools, and we won a district championship 2009, and then again 2012. You know, of course, my reputation is for what I do defensively. You know, my reputation is that is what I'm known for, what I bring on the defensive side of the ball.
Hit it.
Do you see what it looks like? You see how he stopped his feet early? We're playing to the whistle. Keep driving him aside. Here we go.
Go through them.
Level, it's about production, man. You know, we don't favor anybody. If you can play, you can make plays for us Friday night, and you're going to get on the field, you know. So that's what we're looking at right now. Who can make plays for us?
I'm going to miss Santos. Already miss him. Not only as a player, but as a person. You know, good kid, good heart, and I had a great relationship with him. We expect the same thing out of Diego. I told Diego, your job is not to be Santos, it's not to be Adrian, it's to be the best Diego Hernandez you can be. And for those that are not in the know right now, they may think there's going to be a drop-off. For those that have been around this program, those that have seen him perform, the kids in the locker room, the coaches in the offices, he is going to be something special. He has more intangibles probably than anybody we've had here. Plus, he's extremely accurate, extremely intelligent, tough kid, great size, you know, 6'2". I can't wait for the next couple of years to play out. And like I said, that's the next one, the next great quarterback in line. Got to give a lot of credit to our offensive coordinator. You know, Lupin's there, you know, it's his offense. He does a great job with his offense. Coaches the quarterback, does a great job with the quarterback. So our number one priority is to have a trigger. That's our go-to guy. That's what we've had in the past. And that's exactly what we expect Diego to be. But yes, we've been blessed with tremendous quarterbacks, but I credit a lot of that to the coaching staff and their preparation of our offense. You know, all of our offensive coaches do a great job. Our offensive coordinator does an outstanding job. So, you know, just like we've been blessed with great quarterbacks, I've been blessed with a great offensive staff. And, you know, I'm real, real proud of the job that those guys do.
Our strong suit right now would be our offensive linemen. You know, this is the biggest group of kids that I've had since I've been in Mission. You know, I've got about three or four guys that are 6'3", you know, so that gives us a little size on the line. You can take an average back and make him a good, take a good and make him great, you know, because battles are won in the trenches, man. We definitely, you know, have a battle at the quarterback position between right now William Arias and Rudy Trevino. They're battling, you know, and, you know, everybody's getting some touches during the scrimmages. And again, once you go back to film and evaluate film, film doesn't lie. Down here a year ago, it happened to us in 2011, came back and won a district title the following year. You know, we're really working a lot on establishing our core values, you know, our mindset. You know, we've got to change the way, you know, we do things. We got to change really more the mindset and developing good habits. You know, the kids are showing good response. You know, these guys are working extra. On their own, they're taking it upon themselves to do the extra work. You know, we went through a pledge activity. Everybody was responsible for pledging three things they were gonna do above and beyond what we're asking them to do. And right now, they're backing up their work. Fans, you know, there's a certain style that I expect for our players to play, you know, and we're with a chip on our shoulder, man. We're an aggressive unit. We will attack people, you know, and, you know, we play a very aggressive style of play, you know. The bar has been set, and if you don't play that way for me, then you won't get on the field. That's the bottom line.
David Gilpin is a motivator. Oh my goodness. And not to take away from all the great things that he does and scheming and playing matchup wise and making sure that his kids are set up for success. They do that. But he knows how to get into the kids' minds and hearts. And I mean, they look to his leadership and he can point them in any direction and they won't blink and they will go. When you talk about Coach Peña, you talk about a history of excellence. But when you think of Coach Peña, one word always comes to mind: toughness. That man teaches kids to be tougher than steel. And, you know, in the 70s, we talk about the steel curtain of the Pittsburgh Steelers. Man, it's like the Eagle curtain. Nobody's going to score on him.
Year in, year out, regardless of your record, you know, I mean, throw the records out the door, and no matter if you're 0-10, 10-0, you know, all the emotions as a coach, as a player, they come out that night, and it's awesome. It's an awesome feeling to be.
It brings this energy to the city that just lights up the town. And I think that's what separates it. It's about bragging rights. It's about walking in the city and saying, hey, who's top dog in football? That means a lot. It's that type of attitude. And so everybody knows it. And everybody knows they're gonna go to the game and they're gonna watch something special.
Battle of Conway is a Battle of Conway. It's the biggest game in Mission, Texas. And honestly, I find it to be one of the biggest games in the Valley. So everybody's, I like to think that the city is divided. You know, we're always throwing heads at each other. It's always a battle. Academics, football, athletics, anything.
Tonight's atmosphere will tell you everything about how the city feels about football. You know, being 14,000 people, both sides crowded, chanting your name, one side maroon, one side blue, all the hype. It's gonna be a good one. We're all excited.
I feel like it'd be crazy. You know, every year it's crazy. You know, no matter if a team's getting blown out or whatever, it's still just, it's an intense game.
I expect a very good game. And you know, every year, Coach Gilpin has a very good team.
There's been a lot of hype leading up to the game. You know, Mission's going to come out with a lot of emotion, you know, with the tribute to their coach. And
Patriots versus Eagles, and it's going to be an amazing game. The cool thing is, we are Mission. We are Mission. So I don't care if you're East or West, we are Mission.
takes it over with the first down.
We'll be right back. time on the ferry. Nathan Kaufman on the recovery for the Patriots.
Just starting to learn. coaching staff, to all of you. You left no doubt tonight, and that's what we look to do. Proud of you. I'm happy for you, and I ain't gonna take no more of your time tonight. I'm gonna let you go celebrate with your fans and your family as you deserve to do.
I want the audience to see that is what Mission's about. The kids in Mission are trying to put everything on the line and outwork and outthink anybody who's in front of them. And so when they see this game, they see Mission at its finest. And whoever wins deserves it, because it's not going to be handed over.
Remind the kids and everyone that hey, when this game's over, you know, it's about sportsmanship and it's about that's your buddy, that's your brother on the other side.